Google just put an AI brain in a robot. It's another day in the tech world, which means another day of discussing the possibility of robots and AI becoming conscious and surpassing humans. But this time, it's a much different story. Google just put an AI brain in a robot, and scientists cannot seem to get over it. But what makes this robot special? And will it bring us closer to the era of technological singularity? Let's find out. Robots and artificial intelligence go hand in hand. In fact, they've crossed paths a few times in the past, but not in the way you're about to see. Individually, both technologies have grown exponentially in the last few years. We've seen robots like Sophia, Amika, Atlas, and Spot become dominant. At the same time, AI models like DALL-E, GPT-3, and Lambda have dazzled scientists and tech enthusiasts alike. But we were always going to get to a point where someone would attempt to combine the technologies, perhaps out of sheer curiosity. Well, Google just did. The tech company wants to bring robots closer to the human level by teaching them how to understand and respond to spoken language in real time. To do this, the tech giant realized it had to merge the physical capabilities of robots like walking, jumping, and performing simple repetitive tasks with the intuitive abilities of AI systems trained with billions of parameters and texts. Think about it like putting a human brain in a vibrant robot like Atlas. As one of the world's biggest tech companies, Google didn't need to stress too much to get this done. The Silicon Valley giant simply combined its Palm AI model with a basic robot built by everyday robots. And the result of all that hard work is what we've come to know as Palm Seikan, a non-humanoid robot with the most human-like abilities. Palm is a smart natural language processing and machine learning system, and Everyday Robots is a subsidiary of Google's parent company, Alphabet. So it's an in-house thing, but it will inevitably have a resounding effect on the tech industry and the world as a whole. Rather than performing pre-programmed tasks like fixing body panels in automobile factories and arranging goods in warehouses, this robot will be able to understand plain English and perform several tasks based on the instructions given to it. This innovation eliminates the limitations of pre-programmed hard coding and introduces us to a new world of endless possibilities where robots will be able to do just about anything. In a scientific paper that was recently published in the journal Nature, scientists compared the human brain and AI. And interestingly, they found scary similarities between both systems, specifically in the way that they predict words from context and how their numerical activations mirror each other. The AI's internal activity is able to significantly map onto human brain responses to written sentences. So technically, the AI model processes the data and instructs the robot on what to do. According to the paper, the robot will act as the eyes and hands of the artificial intelligence language model, and together they will combine to perform real-life tasks. For instance, if you told the robot something like, "I spilled my drink," or "I am hungry," it immediately consults its database and comes up with a range of possible solutions in the background. After coming up with a list of solutions, it'd select the best option based on its capability. Once this is done, the robot then proceeds to scan the environment to see if it's physically possible to execute the task. In the examples we made earlier, upon receiving your comment, the robot might attempt to clean the spilled drink if there's a mop nearby and it's capable of using it. But if not, it might ask you to do the cleaning yourself. A Google researcher asked this exact question during a demonstration, and convincingly, Palm Seikan made its way to a kitchen in the Google office building using its digital camera and wheels. It grabbed a sponge using its motorized arms before returning to the demonstration room to give it to the scientist. For the second task, the robot might bring you food if there's a ready-made meal in the kitchen. Alternatively, it could make you a meal if the ingredients are available. In one demonstration, popular CNET journalist Claire Riley asked Palm Seikan to make a hamburger. And apart from putting a whole bottle of ketchup in between the wooden block versions of buns, it did just fine. Palm Seikan is a more open-minded and versatile robot and an immense upgrade on conventional robots, which are specifically pre-programmed to do specific tasks. Let's look at some of the most important technologies behind it. The AI brain, PaLM, otherwise known as the Pathways Language Model, is a sophisticated algorithm trained with 540 billion parameters and petabytes of texts sourced from the internet. This vast data bank is what gives PaLM Seikan the ability to understand and interpret plain English language. Some might argue that systems like Siri and Alexa already have the ability to understand human language, but PaLM is superior in this case because it can pass on instructions from humans to a robot that will execute them. Again, drawing some perspective from the example we made earlier, can you imagine what Siri and Alexa would do if you told them you spilled your drink? They'll probably just write you a poem to console you, but it all ends there because Siri and Alexa don't have the required hardware to allow them to clean or cook. To complement the PaLM AI model, Google scientists included another system of code that helps the robot decide which task is feasible and which one is not. This system is called World Grounding Trims. Machine learning is another factor that helps scientists produce robots that can perform on a human level, even in an unstructured and unfamiliar environment. Let's take autonomous vehicles as a case study. Driving is a complex task with many possibilities that can occur, and decisions often have to be made within a split second. Nonetheless, the self-driving systems in cars are able to deal with all of these and perform close to the level of a human driver or even better. This is because the AI brain inside the system has been trained with billions of data and parameters, which allow it to respond to the different possibilities that can occur during driving in real time. In the same way, the radar system on the car is constantly scanning the environment to get the layout and also to identify potential obstacles. Once it gets this information, it sends it back to the AI brains to determine what the car's next move would be. All of these are made possible by the amount of parameters and training the autonomous driving system has received. The same applies to systems like PaLM Seikan, which are designed to excel in an unpredictable and chaotic world like ours. To optimize their performance, scientists might also choose to educate these robots with simulated data. For instance, if scientists wanted to train an autonomous driving system with simulated data, all they need to do is create a virtual network of roads similar to the one the car will be required to navigate in real life. Once the AI system is able to prove that it can navigate this course successfully in a virtual world, it can then be tested in real life. With simulated data, scientists are able to reduce the amount of human-generated data needed to program an AI model. Also, the simulated data technique reduces the number of attempts needed to learn a task from 500,000 to 5,000. Google is not alone when it comes to training robots with simulated data. Microsoft uses the same method to train its newest AI system, and the result is exceptional as well, except that it doesn't perform physical tasks as the PaLM Seikan does. Also, Google went above and beyond to combine the grounding system with another section of code that converts high-level instructions into low-level subtasks that can be executed. Altogether, all of these processes and technology combined are what scientists at the Google Research Lab have been working on in the last few months. And as you can see, the end product is astonishing. In the scientific paper released, Google claims that PaLM Seikan is able to choose the right sequence of skills 8 out of 10 times, with an execution rate of 74%. This represents a significant improvement on the previous study that was released, but the interesting and perhaps scary thing about this robot is that there's no limit on how much it can improve. As we improve the language models, the robotic performance also improves. Carol Hausman, a senior research scientist at Google who helped demonstrate the technology, said, "But as it is with every new robot and AI that is released, some theorists are worried that this robot might bring us one step closer to the technological singularity." Well, it does. But officials don't seem too worried about that, and maybe we shouldn't be as well, especially because the product is still in the research phase. But it is inevitable that sometime in the near future, we'll look back at times like this and either celebrate or regret our unhealthy obsession with developing highly advanced robots and AI systems. What do you make of the PaLM Seikan robot? Is it something you'd be willing to invest in? Let us know what you think in the comments section. Be sure to check out this video over here.